The easiest way to create a vignette in Lightroom is to use the effects panel. This type of vignette is a post-crop vignette, meaning regardless of the crop of your photo, the vignette's going to basically follow with it. And I'll show you that towards the end of this video. Let's start out with the style. We have three different styles: highlight priority, color priority, and paint overlay. Now, to actually show what each of these looks like, I need to first create a vignette. So let's start out by making our vignette. By moving the slider to the right, you can create a white vignette. I tend to prefer darker vignettes, so I'm going to move it to the left. I'm going to make it pretty dark to start out. In fact, I'm going to move it all the way to the left. I normally wouldn't actually use this setting. This is just to show you how the other settings work. The midpoint slider determines basically how big the vignette is from the center out to the edges. It starts out at 50. If I move it all the way to the left, then the vignette moves in closer towards the middle. And as I move it to the right, it moves out. For roundness, you can have either kind of a squared off vignette. And if I move it to the left, you'll see that there. I'm going to actually move that midpoint slider in a little bit so you can see that difference. And that kind of gives it like a film frame look. And as I move it to the right, then that vignette just turns more and more round. You can find kind of like a middle ground that you like best. The feather determines how harsh or how soft the edge is. At zero, it's going to be a much more solid line. And as you move it to the right, then that edge gets more and more feathered. I really like feathered vignettes, so I'll leave it up pretty high. The highlight slider allows the highlights to kind of punch through. It's not really doing anything, and that may be because I have the highlight priority style set. So let's go up to those drop-down settings. The highlight priority style protects the contrast of the highlights in your image. This may change some of the colors, however, in the corners. Color priority is going to protect those colors along the vignette area. And now if I go down to that highlight slider and move it to the right, you can see some of those highlights kind of starting to punch through. So any really bright area that's in that vignette should come through with that highlight slider move to the right. The paint overlay setting adds a much more soft, basically just a matte black or white vignette over your image. This is a good setting to use if you just want a soft vignette or if you are creating kind of a faded matte look on your image. Now that I have this vignette created, let's go to the crop tool and I'll show you how the post-crop vignetting actually works. I'm going to press the R key on my keyboard. And I'll change my aspect to 2x3. You can see that the vignette kind of disappeared when I did that. But if I press the return key, the vignette reappears, and now it's formed around my new crop frame. And then I can change the settings as I need to.